Dedication pays off.
Hello everyone, I am Deepa Srivastava Ahuja, Principal GEMS Education. Today we are going to discuss about coping mechanism. Thank you Vaibhav for giving me an opportunity to speak to our viewers. Coping mechanism, now the topic itself says about the present situation. We all are sailing in the same boat. And this coping mechanism is a part of our every household these days. This is one guest which was not even invited. This guest came uninvited and changed our whole world. All of a sudden, we had somebody living with us without our permissions. We were all locked up inside our houses because of this pandemic. Now let's only talk about the positives that have happened in the last few days. What are learnings that we have taken up? The time is really stressful. It has been a long time where children, elderly persons, even professionals, everybody is just sitting at home. I hear and get a lot of queries from parents. Being an educationist, I deal with children, I deal with parents. I'm getting a lot of queries where parents are really worried and they do not know how to deal with the situation. Children do not have a playing space. Not every household has got the opportunity or has got the facility of giving playing space to children. They're not having ample body movement. Children are in a state of shock, fear and surprise. And see, what are we doing? We're making them more fearful. Everybody is talking about sanitization. Everybody is talking about careful measures that we have to take. Everybody is talking about how to keep yourself safe, which is very important these days. But then how do we tell this to our children? That is again very important. Now we'll just take you through a small discussion where we'll touch upon a few points. How to cope with the situation when everybody is just locked up. So, point number one, I would start as a professional, a mother who's working from home and for home. This was always my desire and dream to be for a while just at home with my family. And so did most of us. When did this came a surprise, because it was not an asked holiday that we were going out or traveling with family. It is just a quiet time that we have got, although not by choice, but it is by chance or almost by force. We are all at home with each other. Let's try and make the most of this time, because this will pass, but this time will never return back. And we all hope that this should not come back like this again, because it is actually a toll on so many lives. We would never pray that this comes back, but let us understand that this too shall pass, but this will never come back again. Now, what do we do? Either we keep on cribbing, get angry and frustrated, or just be busy with our own mobile phones and internet and here and there and crib about not being able to move out of house or make the most sitting inside your household. I know it's not easy at all. I know, well, all said and done, when we say that you read a story with your child, that could be a 5-minute activity, and after that what? Everybody is with the television. What we can do is organize small corners at home that are your happiness corners. You can even make a happiness box. Anything that your child feels happy about, just writes on a piece of paper and puts in that box. Anything that your spouse does for you, you feel happy about it, just put it on a paper and put it in that box. By the end of this lockdown, see how many happiness notes we would have collected. Just doing this activity will also feel a connection. And at the end of the day, we can even count how many persons have got how many happiness counts in that box. And somebody who has not even got one count, then there is a question mark. That person in the family needs to gear up for the next day. When we're talking about sanitizing, it is not only sanitizing our hands, it's actually about sanitizing our thoughts also. Social distancing, as I perceive, is not only that you have to distance from your neighbors, family, relatives, friends, here and there. Social distancing is, let's not peep out in somebody else's world, but peep inside. It is actually a time to revive inside out. Let us actually take time with ourselves. I will not purposefully say yoga and meditation also. It can be some quiet time where you introspect. In retrospect, actually, we have so much to say and give to others. But how many times do we get this opportunity to be with us, ourselves? We can actually make it a routine habit that we sit with ourselves. That is what is called as me time. Calculate some me time for yourself. Stretch out your work schedules and get some time for yourself. Now, how do you get time for yourself? Is too much on the plate. I would just say that it is again in our behavior only. How do we take out time? I'll just read a few words from Rose Milligan. I was just reading an article the other day. Dust if you must. Now, the biggest problem with women at house is that we do not have maids coming in. We have so much to do. All dusting, jhadu, pocha, cooking, washing, everything is there. And then we want to make delicacies also. I've been watching a couple of videos where people are actually cooking like anything. They're having lavish lunch and dinners. Dear friends, once in a while, that is also very good. Maybe a Sunday or a weekend. That is also such a good thing to do for your family bonding. Make children participate. If you're baking a cake, let them help you with the batter. If you're cleaning dishes, let your husband help you with cooking. And so is the husband's to do. If you're really at home and you want to bond with your family members, do stand up and help your family. Maybe help your children getting their toys in the toy basket, or just dance with them on a favorite tune of theirs, or sing a song with them. Maybe a nursery rhyme would do. It's not necessary that you make a plan, timetable, schedule and then follow. And don't force the children to follow that too. See, we as working professionals are in so much of tension, stress and depression. Please allow children to have their own time schedules. Nothing will go upside down if they do not sit with their books for hours and hours every day. Things will come back to normal. It doesn't make a difference that they have not learnt or done their homework today, but it makes a difference that you were angry on them or shouted on them today. We have to cope, so have to they. They were not used to see all of us at home every time. They had a different routine altogether. They had friends to play with. They had classrooms to fiddle with, a lot of things. They had teachers to listen to their stories. We as parents have a lot of roles to play. So we'll have to become their teachers, we'll have to become their mentors, we'll have to become their peers. And so are your wives struggling. A note for wives, so are your husbands in the same boat. We cannot measure and say who's forward and who's not. They are also in stress because there are so many other financial difficulties at this point of time. So let's join hands as a family, make friends in your family members together, because we're not visiting our friends, we're not visiting our relatives, we're not going out anywhere. So can we make friends with each other? And mind you, this happiness box is going to work for you years to come. Whenever there is a tough time or not so good time in family, just go back and refer to the happiness box that this was the time that we have spent together. You can help your children learn life skills at this point of time. I am watching a lot of hue and cry about syllabus completion, you know, course not happening, this not happening, that not happening. See, teaching will still happen, but what has to happen is learning. And this is the time as parents where we can help children to learn. Only teaching will not be suffice. What learning can happen at home is learning life skills, learning some table manners, learning to respect their elders, learning about mythology, learning about history. You can actually recite some nursery rhymes, some poems, or some mythological spiritual stories with them, where they understand the history, the rich history and the rich valor of this country. That is also equally important. So they're learning history. Now, if they have to learn science, they can learn science also. When they help you in kitchen, concepts like evaporation, distillation, condensation, all of this can be learned in the kitchen, working with the mother. They can help you do your cleaning and stuff. That is a part of their life skill. Make them independent now, and they have to learn that this can be the new normal forever, where we might not depend on any help staff or support staff. We have to learn to be independent and work for ourselves and make it a good environment, congenial environment for everybody at home. Your children might move out after a while. Persons working in offices have actually understood the value of their offices. Remember back when we were sitting in our offices, we also always wanted to get back to home. Now, sitting at home for so long, we are actually missing our office tables, missing our work environment. We have learned the value of being a professional. We have now started loving our companies even more than ever. We are all wanting to get back to our places. So, let's make most of this time, let's drop some memories together so that we can relish on these later. We can cherish these memories later. We can relish on the delicacies later, but we can cherish on these memories forever time to come. Because years will go by, maybe we'll, and we wish that we never get this kind of time again where we have to be forcibly be locked up. But we can make some plans that every year we will find some time with our family members where we sit down and read together, eat together, play together, dance together and make some happiness corners in the family. And this last verse while going goodbye, I would say to all the family members out there and especially women, dust if you must. But wouldn't it be better to paint a picture or write a letter, bake a cake, or plant a seed, ponder the difference between want and need. Yes, dear viewers, we have to now understand the difference between want and need. And so, we have to make our children learn about. We all have to go minimalistic. We already are, but this should be again the new normal, that we learn to be minimalistic. We sanitize our thoughts and we understand that less is more. Right now, less is more. See, we are not using all of our wardrobes. We are not using our expensive jewelries. We are not using our luxurious cars. That all became so unimportant so suddenly, so quickly. And we all have almost coped up to this new normal. We've all understood that this is the way that we'll have to live. And some of my friends had been discussing, we are only living in pajamas and that's not making a difference. We are all having a small workplace at home and that's not making a difference. We are all here in the virtual world and that's not making a difference. We, as ladies, have adopted to household work and see how difficult it was in the first week. But now, we all have become masters in washing dishes and cooking. So, we are actually balancing in everything, especially working mothers, I think. The most adaptation that has come is to working mothers and teachers. When this concept of online classes and virtual class environment came up, I really had jitters down my spine. How would we manage a classroom full of children virtually? But see, teachers in this ages, some could be even, you know, elder than me, and some could be even so young who've not even thought of this kind of practice when we can manage a classroom and teach relevant concepts online. Everybody was thinking, how would the children react? Children have taken it so positively. That shows that children have got immense potential of learning. They learn the more we give. So, less is more in kind of our consumptions. Less clothes in the wardrobe, less jewelry in the locker, less number of cars will work, less number of dishes on the table will work. What will not work is wasting this time, complaining, cribbing, cleaning. Now, our houses are the most cleanest at this time because we're doing it all by ourselves, putting a lot of effort in cleaning and everything is shining, sparkling. But you know what? Nobody is coming to see that. They will only see you when you go back to mess. So again, that's not very important. The important thing is how do we cope and not criticize, not complain, not waste this time, but make some memorable memories. I would once again thank Vaibhav for giving me this opportunity. I think I have given some food for thought. Kindly think about these ideas and suggestions and come back to us in case you have any queries. I would be really happy to reply you with suggestions if I can. Thank you so much.